Yo! What up, guys, and welcome back to another one. Yes, it is still snow goose conservation season, and we're out here. Me and Jordan are out here for a little two-man hunt. It is extra cold. It's been, just ridiculously cold in Kansas for, it's probably been a week and a half now, and the snow geese are here. I mean, my area is piling up. Birds are spilling in from the south, headed north, and they're hitting Kansas, or hitting the central area, the central part of Kansas, and they're just stalling up because of the cold. Nebraska still has a ton of snow, so we are just literally loading up with birds. We have birds everywhere. How are they going in there?
I've had easier days, but you know.
So the bad thing is, here's the crucial bad deal. The ground's frozen. It's hard to get these in the ground. We're using nothing but 15 dozen full body whites today. That's what we got to get up. But real quick, our snow goose conservation hoodies are on sale 20% off Friday and Saturday. I will link these bad boys down in the description. Go pick you one up, save you some jack. But I'm gonna put the camera down. I'll pick it up right when we're done. We gotta get an A-frame up. We gotta get all these full bodies in the ground. It's gonna take a minute. It is 12:30. These birds have been bouncing from water to feed to water to feed all day. And that's probably what they're gonna do all day because it's cold. Oh my goodness, we just got sat down. The birds got up. We're in lay down blinds. Jordan right beside me here and behind us. Look at these birds. Holy smokes. So that's a body of water we're set up about 300 yards away from. They just got out of the field and came to water. So literally just got sat down, fired up the e-collar. It's only like 1:30 in the afternoon. This cold weather, gloomy weather. Got them jumping around all day. Let's see if we can do something. Oh yeah, looking juicy today. So like I've been saying, I want to hunt these snow geese like they're honkers. Hold on, let me turn. Goodness gracious, that's loud, man. And actually that's not very loud. I only have it at like 30% volume. So what we did is me and Jordan, we sat, probably only about 10, 12 dozen full body snow geese out here. Oh yeah, that looks good. That looks good. And then we got two lay down blinds rocking out right here. And we're on a little road that goes in between the field here. And there's a ton of birds literally roosting right by us. This is a big feeding ground. We're winging it. I didn't want to set a big spread like I said. These are old birds, they're all adults. So low volume on the e-collar is number one. Oh my goodness, that's a lot of birds. We better get back in. Low volume on the e-collar, hunt them like they're honkers. That's my theory this year. Holy smokes, look at all these birds. Got the e-collar off right now. Woo, doggy. I'm gonna kick it on right as they go over the top. I'm gonna kick this e-collar on. Oh my goodness, this is a sight. Wow. Oh my lordy, this is insane, guys. Not gonna lie, look at that, dude. Look at this, this is beautiful. Look at these two right here. I don't know if we ought to shoot and waste all this for two birds shooting. We better wait a minute. Oh, look at them loving it, dude. Oh, look at this. Yeah, they like it. Oh yeah. Look at this. Oh boy, howdy. Oh goodness, look at the left, dude. Get ready. Oh my, dude, there's Canadas in there. I don't really want to spray. Yeah, let's. Yeah, we can't spray into that. That's a juvie. Look at him. That's a juvie. He's a young bird. Oh, this is intense. Yeah, we could have sprayed into that, but I do not know what all was in there. Woo! My heart's pumping. Oh, look at this. We could have had one go at him, but there was a lot of mixed birds in there. I am not gonna take my chances on shooting something I'm not supposed to. Gotta be careful here. But we are seeing some juvies, so this could get interesting.
All right, now we got a really good group coming at us. Come on, give it up. Just watch your shots. Place your shots. Here we go. Really nice group here. Look at them in front. Look how low they are. They're not even that, they're like 10 foot. If they come to us, we're gonna shoot that low bunch. Come on, get over here. We got a really nice group working out in front of us here. They like it, but they're taking a while to make up their mind what they want to do here.
Oh, that big volley came. My heart started racing. We couldn't shoot. There was just too many mixed specs in there in Canada's. So I'm not all about flock shooting. I don't. It can get dangerous. Especially, you got to know what species are around, and you have to really pay attention to it. You just can't just go busting into them. So we're going to concentrate on small flocks. We missed a lot of goats to shoot some birds, but it's okay. Got some good content on here, I hope, for you guys. But now we're gonna start shooting. That's for sure.
See that Canada right there?
Yep,
four Canadas mixed in right there. That's what's scary about this. We're really just gonna have to pick our shots. We're not gonna flock shoot.
I'm not even shooting blues, I'm shooting all white.
Yeah, if I pull the trigger, it's gonna be on a white bird. I'm not even gonna try to pick out a blue.
Shoot a blue, but
this is beautiful though, I'll tell you what. Sorry I got you all on the GoPro. It's hard to run that camera right now. I'm ready to shoot.
I'm absolutely loving this nose down low system. This is the app. I hope you can see it, but we'll pause it for a minute. Oops, sorry, that ain't pausing. That's playing another track. Boom. But here's the caller. I'm getting some weird feedback. I think because I'm running this cheap Bluetooth rig. This is just a cheap one that I found, but it's kind of doing some fuzzy business. But I'm pretty sure it's this cheap. This cheap Bluetooth is just making it sound fuzzy when you don't have it going. But here it is, here's a setup. It's really neat. It's got a couple USB chargers where you can charge your phone, or just like this Bluetooth device, you can charge it. But yeah, you get this little Snows Down Low app, play some juiciness. I mean, they just love it. But if y'all want to check out the Snows Down Low e-collar, I will link it in the description below if you want to check him out. Jameson is a great guy, builds a very, very quality product. Hunt them like honkers, you know, that's how we have the snow geese sit out here, full bodies only. And I like this idea. All the feeds that I've seen of snow geese around here that are in tall stalks, just like this field is, they line up in the rows just like this, and they walk down the rows. So it may look like, man, he's got them in straight lines, but in all reality, it's very real when you do that. So we're adjusting the spread a little bit, getting ready for them to come back. Like I said, days like this, gloomy days, they just stay out and they feed all day and they bounce around. That's what they're doing today. That's what they did yesterday too. So, but I hope I caught that on a video good enough for you guys. I was trying to juggle my head mount and when I was going to call the shot. And I mean, they gave it up probably twice. But they're in such big wads. There was one go that we could have hammered on them at 20 yards, 25 yards. But I was looking and it was like, oh, there was a lesser, there's a lesser, there's a speck. There's a bunch of white, but man, they're mixed in. You can't risk it for the biscuit for that. It's not worth it, boys and gals. But if you're liking this little two-man snow goose hunt so far, and my theory of hunting them like they're honkers, you gotta hit that thumbs up button right now for your boy. Well, the field just got up yet again, and this will be round two if they all come back over. I don't think they're all going to come back over like they did last time. Look at that. So that's the water behind us. The whole field got up yet again, and they're going to that piece of water. It's a very, very small pond. Very small cattle pond. Woof, that's a lot of birds.
Oh, look at this. Oh, yeah, boys. Oh man, they really diverted our path. Wow. There we go. Woo! Four.
Nice.
Four of them. Oh, I lost my breath because this jerky's so hot.
We're just shooting.
We just killed four pigeons. Woo! Well, at least we're on the board.
Pigeon rain out.
I can't even talk because this jerky's so hot. But we just had a group of pigeons come right over the top, and we just smoked them. Look at this guy. He's stuck on the ice. Come here, fella. Oh, yeah, that was cool, dude. They came right over the top, locked up, and we just laid down the hammer, dude. Boom. God, that was cool.
That was awesome.
That was real cool. No e-collar on or anything. The old pigeons just loved it.
Standing out here like, hey, look, pigeon.
Yeah.
Go sit down. You want to try them?
Yeah. That was perfect, dude. That was bad. Well, we're on the board. We are on the board. Here's our sleeping situation back here. Old pigeon the blind, baby. Holy cow. Wow, look at this. Oh my goodness. This is beautiful. Wow. Oh God, wanna shoot him? Shoot him. Got one. They're getting up, boys. My hat fell off. Well, my hat fell off. You're back on. We got them all up. We killed one, though. The first shot, he went. We couldn't get the second one, though. They all got up.
Got hit, but.
Yeah, he got hit. Well, we didn't get skunk. We got some pigeon down. We got one snow goose down. See if we can get into some more here now that they're all up. Oh, boy. That was awesome, though. It's time to, my deal is, look, we could have waited and waited, but we've waited long enough. We need to shoot something.
Well, first snow goose down. Man, that is loud out here. Holy smokes. I've got it turned down to like 25%. It's low. But we had that double come over. Had a lot of geese look at us for a while now. We haven't taken a shot on them. The only thing we shot was pigeons. So I'm like, you know what? We gotta take him. Well, I was hoping we'd get them both down, but we only got one. But got the skunk out of the bag. Pigeons and snow geese, baby. Goodness, dude. Looked like you got a swan or something over there. It's telling you what. Them adults are huge. They're pretty, though, aren't they?
Oh, yeah.
They are. They're beauts. That's a big bird, dude. Almost as big as a honker, dude.
Getting close.
Oh, this is fun though. You know, these are the type of snow goose hunts I really like, when you can kick back, there's only a couple of you, you got the e-collar working for you, you don't put out a bunch of decoys. That's what's nice. A lot of you know, a lot of you guys snow goose hunt too, and you know when you sit out a bunch of decoys, especially when the ground, man, I'm telling you, when it's hard like it is right now, it absolutely, it's not any fun sitting out big spreads. So this small little full body spread, I am game.
Absolutely love it. This is what's really cool about sitting these white spreads. You get to watch all these other birds just love it. Can't shoot them, but you can sure watch them just give it up. These specks love it, man. Look at this group of specks, just loving it. They might land, actually. Beautiful.
Well, it is now right at 5:30. We still have like an hour and a half of shooting left. As a lot of you know, conservation season, you can shoot 30 minutes before sunrise and 30 minutes after sunset. So, me and Jordan, we've been out here by ourselves all day. We really don't feel like picking up in the dark. Plus, it's already getting really cold now that the sun's went down. Well, my hair's probably crazy. Let me tell you what. We are done. We're done picking up here. We called it. Like I said, we're about 45 minutes, 50 minutes early from regulation. But let's check out our big old pile here. We put a pile down, boy.
Oh, man.
Oh, just a pile, let me tell you. Oh, yeah! Woo! But this hunt was fun, you know. Again, I'm going to say it again. Man, I wish we could have shot into the wad that did it extremely well. I mean, my goodness. But there was too much collateral. I am not about taking, I'm not a risk taker when it comes to waterfowl hunting. You can't be. But big old piles today, let me tell you what. But it was fun though. We got one hard look. So my two cents on the whole hunt 'em like honkers, I think it worked because for one, they all came and looked at us really, really, really hard. I mean, we, like I said, we could have shot a lot, but we didn't on that first volley that came. I can tell you what, if we were laying out here in socks and white painter suits, I don't think they would have looked at us that hard. They wouldn't have gave us that close of a go. We didn't take the shot. We washed and we awed and we drooled. But I can guarantee you, being out of these decoys and the old laydown blinds back here, I guarantee you, getting out of them decoys is what did it. They really like it. Now, we don't have a pile to show for it, like it went well at all, but, you know. Snows are tough, guys. I mean, I can sit here and act like I know everything under the sun and give you my two cents and try to act like I know everything, but at the end of the day, these birds are tough. Usually, the only way to get them down in the spread is weather. Weather, hard weather. So, it was a fun hunt. We got to get a good look at some juveniles that are very rare this year. It's like seeing a, it's literally like seeing a unicorn. But I want to thank you all for being here. I hope you enjoyed this little two-man snow goose conservation hunt. It's always nice sitting out the collar and see how the birds react. I really enjoy filming the specks doing it and filming the other species that we can't shoot at, but just watching them and filming them doing it. So if you guys like this video, give your boy a big old thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, you need to. And like I said earlier, 20% off all snow goose gear on the DUXWaterfowl.com website. So I will link it all down in the description below. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for the view. We'll see you on the next one. Peace.